Welcome back to Let's Learn Ukulele. And today we're going to learn a classic folk song from John Denver, because every stringed instrument should have a John Denver song that goes along with them. And so today we're going to be learning Leaving on a Jet Plane, which we were joking that no one is doing right now because. So today we're going to be learning a couple of new chords. Again, we're just adding chords to our repertoire, the ones that we already have are C and G. Still getting better on G.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then we have A minor, and then we have F, and then we have D minor seventh.
Oh. I'll jump to that one then. Okay.
Remember, do an F.
Yes. F.
Bring the finger
extra.
Back. Yep.
Ish.
Yes, got it. Then we have E minor. And then we have E7. One of my favorites. And today we're going to add some more jazz chords, one of them being C suspended. So this is a really simple one to learn. What you're going to do is you're going to play C. Then you're going to take that first finger and you're going to place it in the where the first fret is. And that's C sustained or suspended. Isn't that lovely?
Ooh.
It's very wistful.
Yeah.
So I love songs with this chord in it. Coldplay uses this chord a lot. I love it. So you'll usually go from C. That's what we'll be doing. And it's just very whimsical and full of whimsy. So then the next chord we're going to learn is G7. This is a great chord to have in your repertoire. You can play almost anything now. You've got all these chords, but you're going to do, it's like an upside down G.
Okay.
So what you're going to do is you're going to place your first finger on the second string in the first fret area. Then you're going to place your second finger in the second fret area on the third string. And then you're going to have your third finger go back on our first string in the second fret space. There. Yep. So that's G7. And then we're adding some jazziness to it. We're going to reach up and place our baby finger on the next fret. So we're going to go from G7 suspended to G7. So these are two of the chords that we're going to be using today, along with C suspended, or C sus is everybody calls it, that I know who are musicians. So this is a relatively simple song. We're using C, F, G, and A minor, G7 and A minor. So instead of using G, which is harder, I feel like G7, once you get used to it, is going to be easier to get into.
Yeah.
Because I always just think of it as it's G upside down. And it's got some of the earthier tone in it. So especially with folk songs and with jazz chords, you'll get a lot of G7 and G7 suspended. So we're going to be using those in Leaving on a Jet Plane. So the first part of the song is the intro. And that one we're just using C and C suspended, C, C suspended, C. Then we're gonna go over to A minor, then come back to G7. And that's gonna give us kind of a jazzy intro into the song.
Okay.
So the first line, all my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. That's C and F. And those are our old friends. We're just gonna rock from C to F, back to C, back to F. Okay, so shall we do the first line?
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna start on all my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. And then the next line is C, A minor, G7. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. And how this song is written, they're gonna do this little fun G7 at the end of that line, because it's a very longing song. So they're going to use that the suspended note to add the longing. So how that line goes is, I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blown his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could cry. Good. Now the chorus is, again, the first line, same thing we've been playing, C, F, C, F. Then we're going to go to C, A minor, G7. So exactly what we've been playing. then we get to the second verse.
Okay.
So should we start at the beginning?
Yeah, let's do it.
Do you want to do the intro?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. So we're just going to do C, C suspended, C, C suspended, C, A minor, G7, G suspended, G7. All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I reached too far. I went too far. 'Cause I'm a leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. So you'll notice when we get 'cause I'm leaving on a jet plane, we're going to... The last note we played is G7.
Yeah.
And if you want to, you can do, 'cause I'm leaving. 'Cause we're not actually hitting the C until ven.
Yeah.
On leaving. So, 'cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. So we're going to get some fun syncopation in there. So don't be afraid of it. Again, if I'm writing this on my music, I'm going to circle leave-in because it's going to be difficult. And I'm going to point at vin on leave-in. to say, hey, don't sing the C until we get to leaving on, and then we'll move on to the F. Okay? So, shall we go to the next verse?
Yes.
Okay. As you can see, as you learn more chords, you get more confident, you get your uke secured, you get more confidence, and so you can get through songs faster.
I am much more confident with this song than Over the Rainbow.
That is quite understandable. quite understandable. Okay, let's go to the second verse. There's so many times I've let you down. So many times I've played around. I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. See, I went too far too. So we want to get our pinky right between the third fret, and our finger. So we're going to nudge up against our ring finger as much as we can, and not overstretch, because then it's going to sound weird like that. And we want it to sound like this, because that's pretty. So let's do that line again.
Sure.
I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I think of you. Every song I sing for you. When I come back, I'll wear your wedding ring. And of course, you can change the words to "you'll wear my wedding ring," depending on what you decide you like the best. So let's go to the chorus. Now the time has come. Let me leave you one more time. Let me kiss you, then close your eyes, and I'll be on my way. Dream about the days to come. See, I'm going to circle that one too, because dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. So, dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the time I won't have to say. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. I didn't hit that note right. Should we go back to that one?
Yeah.
So G7, let's make sure that we know where our fingers are going.
Is that third finger?
Third finger, getting it right. So third finger, so first finger should be on the second string. Yep. Second finger should be on the third string. Third finger should be on the first string.
It's the, yeah.
There we go.
Little third finger at all, it was that second.
And then we add our little pinky finger, our weak little pinky finger. We're at "Hold Me Like You'll Never Let Me Go."
Yeah.
Hold me like you'll never let me go. To go. And then you repeat it.
Yeah.
So now is the time to really challenge ourselves.
Oh no.
We're gonna do some strumming.
Okay.
Because we know that we can do it like this.
Yes.
Okay. So with this song, I would do the first verse the way we've been doing it. Okay. It's very longing. It's very whimsical. It's, you can just picture somebody on a doorstep singing with their ukulele. So I would play it that way. When I get to the chorus of So Kiss Me and Smile for Me, that's when I'd start strumming. And what I do is, we're going to do again, down, down, up, up, down, up. Okay? So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. So that's going to be different. Let me go. I would probably do, hold me like you'll never let me go. Very good. Yeah. Very good. 'Cause I'm a does not want to do it.
It is protesting.
It's protesting because we don't use this finger for anything other than maybe makeup application because it doesn't hurt our eyes, but it doesn't do much. So we're going to build the strength of our hand using the ukulele. That finger is going to become an anchor for us, believe it or not. Especially when we've got chords where we're using all four fingers.
Yeah.
Those get really involved and super fun because they're usually jazz chords. And so they're giving us fun things to do. So let's do Oh Babe, I Hate to Go again.
Sure.
Oh babe, I hate to go.
Don't worry, I skipped A minor. It's fine.
It's all right. So let's try that again and not skip A minor.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think we're probably gonna go. Oh, babe, I. Does that make sense? We're gonna hit the C first, and then go into the A. So. Again, when you're on your own playing, finding what works for you. Yeah. And this is another one that you can play along to. So if you've got a John Denver album, if you've got an MP3, anything available. One of my favorite things to use is from the library is Freegal.
Yeah.
Where you get access to music to stream. And John Denver is one of the many artists that Freegal has on that you can listen to, and if you can find the song, it's great to play along to.
Yeah.
So don't forget that resource that we have from the library. You should be able to log in with your library card and your PIN. So let's think about playing along to John Denver and working on what works for us. Basically, there's a little bit of a cheat on the down, down, up, up, down, up. Mm-hmm. That's down, down, up, up, down, up. We're doing... It's almost like we're forgetting the last.
Yeah.
Down, up, down, up. Up, up, down, up. Yep. You know what I mean. And that's okay. Being able to say, okay, too many strums there. I'm going to make sure to do it this way so that it works for me. So let's go to the chorus. I'm still strumming. Now the time has come. Now the time has come. Let me leave you one more time. Let me kiss you. Close your eyes and I'll be on my way. Dream about the days to come, when I won't have to leave alone. About the time when I won't have to loud, especially if I'm serenading someone on their doorstep. Mm-hmm. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. I get quieter. Oh, babe, I hate to go. And that is a song, Leaving on the Jet Plane. We've given you some of the music in the slides. Hopefully, you'll be able to look at it and play along with us. This is from Dr. Uke. Again, a great resource, druke.com. And it's Leaving on a Jet Plane. He has literally hundreds and hundreds of songs, probably even 1,000.
Easily.
Of songs that have this great format where it shows you, it gives you the chord chart and then shows you where your fingers are supposed to go. So especially for beginners, and if you ever want to get jazzy, he's a really great place to go because he'll give you the little things at the end of the line that you play that make people think, oh, you really know what you're doing. And you're like, really? Really, I don't. But I play like I do. And that's one of the great things. One of the things I talked about that, yes, I would bring is the capo. A capo is a device that goes on... Let's see what key do I want to be in. That goes on our instrument and makes it so we can do things in different keys without changing the fingering. Because the minute you do a half step up, your fingering changes. So if you're singing a song like Somewhere Over the Rainbow, mm-hmm, now... You can still do the same. So the capo becomes this fret part. And yeah. There we go. I was like, that's too jazzy. So we've got C. It sounds really high because a uke is a small instrument. pressing so high or so low on that song. So a capo is a wonderful thing to have. For a ukulele, you can find capos that are made for ukuleles, but your best shot is going to be to either get a mandolin capo, or this is actually a banjo capo, and it works really nicely with my ukulele. Nice. So I like it a lot. But again, it moves everything up a step for you so that you don't have to change your fingering. So capos are fun things to have for your ukulele accessories. Having a good case that's hard-sided is a really nice thing to have. Mine has straps on it, so you can wear it like a backpack. But the key to playing the ukulele is really just having fun. Finding those songs online for the tabs that you want to play, things that are fun for you. My husband always requests that I play Def Leppard on my ukulele because it sounds so fun. And Metallica, that's our other favorite songs to play, are Metallica songs and some Nine Inch Nails in there. Because it sounds so funny on this cute little happy ukulele. It's just so fun. So you've got to find things that make you happy, that make you smile. Find songs that you want to learn and play them. Play them a lot until you get to the point where you feel super comfortable. And then sing along. Have people come and sing along with you. Have people come to your house for a party and pull out your ukulele and be like, it's time to play. And everybody is happy to sing along. It can be one of the funnest things that you will ever do, is have a ukulele sing-along party. And just have music printed out and say, this is what I'm learning. And people are happy with whatever level you're at. They really are. It's a fun thing to do while you're stuck at home learning the ukulele. It's something that will continue having programs at the Provo City Library for ukulele programs, because we have ukuleles at the library, one of which Melinda is playing. Yep. But really, this is just a fun thing to do. You too can play the ukulele. It just takes some time and building up your finger strength and some patience with yourself.
Yes.
Self-compassion is the biggest key with this. Self-compassion, so that you can play and not get mad at yourself for making mistakes. But that's what we've got. Shall we play through it one more time?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Okay, let's do the intro. I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. But the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. Taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome, I could cry. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm a leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll Thanks for joining us. We hope you have fun. We've loved playing ukulele with you, and we hope that you have a great day.
Yeah.